Hey, Kevin John, Black Hollywood Live, and I'm standing in the middle of two stars of the upcoming episode on Criminal Minds, the Hall of Famer, Michael Irvin, and the Hall of Actor,
Shamar. Glory days.
The glory days.
I'm a wannabe Michael Irvin, like a lot of us.
If I can be like Mike, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Now, the funny thing is, you guys both have an extensive and prolific background in sports. How are you guys going to be able to use those athletic gifts to further enhance this scene today when you're going to be running?
You know what I believe, and Derek's done a great job. I'm calling him Derek. Derek, I am a true friend. But he's really done a good job of really making this feel like a locker room since coming on the set, coming by and joking. And he, as an athlete, knows once you get that locker room feel, everything else will work out.
Yeah. Now, Shamar, you're going against a Hall of Famer here who has once been clocked at a 4.5 140. Is there any kind of intimidation or fear that you feel having to run against him in the scene?
My muscles are strictly for television, okay? This is all pretend. Once upon a time, they used to work, okay? I had some gas in my tank. I could run around a little bit, but he is a Hall of Famer for real. I am for pretend, okay? Derek Morgan is a bad man. Shamar Moore is no dummy. See, but, you know, having Mike on the show is just cool. I mean, this is a Hall of Fame, one of the best to ever play the game. And he's standing here, but it's true. And Dallas is my number two team.
Number one?
Well, because in my generation, which is his generation, it was Joe Montana. I was Bill Walsh's paper boy in seventh grade.
Get out of here!
It was Willie Mays' paper boy in seventh grade.
That's San Francisco Giants.
Yeah, so it was Joe Montana followed by Steve Young. It was Freddie Solomon, Ronnie Lott.
John Taylor.
Jerry Rice, John Taylor. And then over there in Texas, was Michael Irvin, Deion Sanders, Troy Aikman, Emmitt Smith.
Jay Novacek.
Yeah, but to have him here and for a good cause. And he was talking about the locker room. Mike doesn't have to do nothing but be Mike. He doesn't have to act. He just got to be Mike. That's enough. And it's for a good cause. So Derek's got a pretty cool best friend. But you know, Shamar and Mike, we all right too in real life. But today,
I see.
You know, but today we're coming together for the kids, man. It's about, you know, Mike wasn't born like that. He didn't wake up like that. He had to work hard to accomplish what he did. And we want young kids to believe in dreams, believe in themselves, so they can be like Derek Morgan or Michael Irvin.
Well, I'll definitely say Michael was born with a lot more than I do. So now, you know, it's funny. A few days ago, you were the honorary first pitch for the Dodgers game. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm bringing it up. Now, you know.
That go?
Can you explain what happened?
I choked. You know what? I played baseball in college. I was really pretty good at college.
Too, right?
I did, and I did it in Fenway Park in Boston, where my family's from. And my uncle looked me dead in the face on the third base side and said, "Don't bounce it." The number rule in baseball of throwing out first pitches. You can throw it. You can do not your best, but you don't bounce it. And I was at Dodger Stadium the other day, warmed up, had it together, knew what I was doing, and I got nervous. I got out on that mound, and I got nervous, and I said, "Watch this." And me and Mike were just talking about it, like trying to show people we still got it.
Right?
And got it. Yeah. And so I was like, "I'm going to show them. I'm trying out for the Dodgers today." And I wound up, and I tried to put some mustard on it, and I bounced it 45 feet. And I was like, all I could think of was my uncle and how embarrassed he's going to be. And I was just like, I'm that guy right now. Because as soon as I let the ball go, I was like, "No, give it back. I wanted another try."
Yeah.
But there was no another try.
There's no do-overs when it comes to, you know. I thought of 50 cents first pitch against the Mets.
Mine was better than 50.
Okay. I'm not comparing to 50 cents now. That's the difference.
Okay.
My ball went straight. It went straight. It just, I bounced it.
He went to another area code.
Yeah,
but
I got 50 beat. Now, I do want to redeem myself, but I will be the first one to say I came up short.
Yeah, you did. Well, as long as you acknowledge it, honesty is the first step to any kind of recovery. So I definitely respect that. Now, you said your number one team was the Niners, followed by the Cowboys. Obviously, we know that you were a Cowboys legend. Yeah. This year, the Seahawks have been ranked as the number one team to beat in the league. I think the Cowboys weren't even in the top 10 on that list. What is your reaction to that, and do you feel that they have a legitimate chance?
Well, if you're a Cowboys, that's great. You're ranked there. Hopefully you can sneak up on somebody. And what you do, you go into training camp saying, "Hey, they're not giving us any respect." Mm-hmm. And we're the only team that went into Seattle and beat Seattle last year. And that they have them number one. So you take that as fuel. Like Derek was just talking about. I watch the show all the time. This is all I know, you know. But like Shamar was just talking about, you know, San Francisco. When I got in the league, They were everything. Mm-hmm. And you know, seeing Joe Montana and Jerry Rice, I was like, okay, you're the best. I'm going to go snatch it from you. That's why we had such great rivalries. Yeah. That's what makes it great. It's the rivalries. It's the challenges. And they, Dallas has that opportunity this year.
They do. Well, hopefully, they got their number 88 signed. So.
And that's the important part. If you got my son that wears my number signed, that means you got a chance at winning the number of Super Bowl rings I have, which are three.
There you go. We'll see what we do. Well, thank you so much. We definitely hope you guys win a Super Bowl out here on the field today. So, good luck to the boys. And I hope you get a chance to pitch again for the Dodgers.
Yeah,
so we can get a take two.